All right, welcome back, everyone. It's Nohai here, and we are back with another top 5 legendary weapons list here in Borderlands 3. And in this one, we are going to be going over assault rifles. So I picked out what, in my opinion, are the 5 best assault rifles in Borderlands 3 at the moment. Keep in mind that my list may differ from your list. Your favorite weapons in the game or assault rifles or whatever I go over may be different from your favorites in the game. For example, you know, some of the weapons on this list may not work as well in certain builds, and there may be other weapons out there that work really well in certain builds but may not work well in another one, but that may be the build you use, so that may be your favorite weapon. So feel free to leave any corrections you would make to my list down in the comment section below. But I picked out 5 that I think are the best. I've also picked out 2 honorable mentions that we will go over before we go over the number 1 on this list that I think definitely deserve to be in the conversation as well. They were very close. This was a very close one for me. The 5 I picked out, I got it down to a pool of 7. I finally got the 5 picked out that I think were the best. And the 2 extra ones, it was like really close, so I decided to throw them in as well as 2 honorable mentions in the list. Before we get too far into the video, though, feel free to leave this video a like and subscribe. And if you do subscribe, feel free to hit that bell icon. That way you get notified each and every time I upload a brand new Borderlands video. Also, feel free to use my Epic Games creator code. It'll be in the description anytime you're buying something on the Epic Store or anything like that. If you want to use it, you can. If you don't, that's fine also. But it'll be a cool little way to support me if you wanna do that. Also, 2 more things before we get into it here. 1, the weapons that I picked out in this video are weapons that I have tested on all 4 of the characters, me myself personally, with different varying builds. And these are the 5 best that I've picked out that I think are the best pretty much on every single character. Also, I will have guides on each one of these weapons down in the description. I've made guides on every single one of these weapons. I will put that all those guides down in the description below, including the 2 honorary mention video weapons. They will also be down in the description below because I am pretty positive that I've made guides on every single one of them. But yeah, that's pretty much all I got. Let's get into this top 5 list. Alright, so coming in at number 5 on my list is going to be the Soul Render. The Soul Render is a legendary Dahl assault rifle that can only be obtained in the campaign DLC 2, the Hammerlock's Wedding DLC. This weapon can come in any element, including non-elemental, and it drops from the boss Tom and Xam. They are actually 2 separate little bosses that are located in the Heart's Desire within the DLC. This weapon, it fires units normally, and then it has a chance of spawning these homing explosive purple ghosts while firing the weapon. As you're going to see that throughout the gameplay. And that's going to be your main damage dealer also. The normal bullets on this thing do pretty good damage. But the homing purple skulls is what really makes this weapon, I think, a top 5 weapon. Just how much damage they do. You're going to see how much damage they do throughout the gameplay. It's a really, really good damage. As you can see right there, that guy just got absolutely destroyed. This guy gets destroyed. I mean, these purple, and especially since they're homing too, so you don't really have to have them, you know, perfectly aimed in on a person. They can't really move out of the way. They will home in on that person they're going for, and it's pretty much a guaranteed hit on them. That's another reason it's so good. I honestly don't think this weapon would be as good if the skulls were not homing, because you would not get that consistent damage where it would pretty much always lock in on your target. But since they are homing and they will just lock in, it really helps out with the damage a lot, and it, you know, it makes it to where you don't have that chance of missing. It pretty much just locks on to the person, and you're pretty much always guaranteed to get that extra damage on top. And in this case, with this weapon, in my opinion, the skulls are your main damage. Like, it's dealing more damage than just the bullets itself. It's a really good weapon, and it definitely deserves to be in the 5th spot. Alright, so coming in at number 4 is going to be the legendary Vladov assault rifle, the Sickle. The Sickle comes in any element, including non-elemental. You can get it from Anointed X4 during the mission Malevolent Practice in the Anvil. This thing is an assault rifle. This thing's a little bit unique here, okay? So this thing is in the assault rifle class, but it is basically a fully automatic shotgun. You can really tell by how many pellets this thing shoots out at a time. The pellets shoot in the form of a sickle, I'm pretty sure. And this thing honestly is a beast. Even though, you know, you might get a little bit confused, you know, like, hey, this is might you know, this should be a shotgun, this should be ranked in the shotgun class, but it is counted as an assault rifle, as you can tell by the little logo bottom right. And if you look it up, it is counted as an assault rifle, even though, you know, technically it is a shotgun. And this thing has a insane fire rate, and it is really good. There's also a prefix on this thing you can get called the boom. You can get something called the boom sickle, and it is probably the best version of this assault rifle. But even just the regular version of it, as you can see right here, is just putting in work. This thing, I love this gun. It's easily one of my favorite gun weapons in Borderlands 3. I love it. And it is really good right now. I remember it's went through a couple stages. You know, a lot of weapons around when Mayhem 2 was first coming out did not do that well. And this was one of them, if I remember back. If I remember correctly, it might be one of, I might be wrong on that. But if I remember correctly, it did struggle a little bit. But since then, it's made a very good comeback. And it's one of the better assault rifles, as you can tell by my list here in the game. And I definitely recommend you go out and get one, specifically... I have trouble saying that word, sorry, but specifically the boomsickle version. The boomsickle version is an amazing weapon. It's pretty much always been a good weapon throughout the entirety of Borderlands 3's lifespan so far. And I definitely recommend you go out and get that one. But even just the base version definitely deserves to be in the number 4 spot. Alright, so coming in at number 3 is going to be the Rebound. The Rebound is a COV legendary assault rifle that can only be obtained within DLC 4. The Psycho Krieg DLC. The Rebound can drop as any element, including non-elemental. It can only drop from Psycho Reaver in the during the quest Locus of Rage in Vault Hala. Basically, this thing, this assault rifle, shoots dynamite attached to saw blades. That's what you're going to see bouncing around all the map here. These saw blades will actually bounce around for a little bit before they explode. They have dynamite attached to them. This weapon has been good pretty much since the DLC came out. It's been one of the better assault rifles in the game ever since it released. And this thing, I mean, you can see how much damage it's doing here in the gameplay. It's just shredding through stuff. You have the saw blades that just bounce around everywhere, dealing extra damage to extra enemies they hit, because they actually bounce around for a good little bit before they actually explode, and you're pumping out so many shots, they're just flying around the map everywhere. I would say that if you have a low-end, like, gaming PC or something like that, or probably if you're on console, you're going to be experiencing a little bit of, you know, maybe FPS drop with this thing, because I have just a little bit in some cases, because this thing does put out a lot of, like, just bouncing saw blades everywhere, especially if I'm using, like you just saw, I was in fadeaway, and it has, like, that little purple effect on it. Sometimes my frames will drop. Most of the time it doesn't happen, but sometimes it will. Because, I mean, just look at them flying everywhere. But, I mean, this thing just deals massive damage. It's really good. Like I said, it's been one of the better assault rifles in the game pretty much since DLC 4 came out and we found out about it. And it continues to be right now. It is definitely, in my opinion, the third best assault rifle in the game. You know, you may have a different opinion, but this is definitely a very good assault rifle. And it deserves to be in the third spot. Alright, so coming in at number 2 is going to be the legendary Jacobs Assault Rifle, the Clairvoyance. The Clairvoyance can only be obtained within Campaign DLC 2, the Hammerlock Wedding DLC. It can only come in cryo damage. It drops from a crew challenge enemy called Critchy, I think that's how you say that, and its location is Curse Haven. Basically, what this thing does is it crit sticks projectiles which later explode. You're going to notice whenever you hit a crit with this thing, sometimes you'll get like little stickies, kind of like Torg stickies. And that's going to be a really big damage dealer for you. Normal shots with this thing deal massive damage, as you can see. But once you hit those crits with this thing, and you get the little stickies, and those stickies, after they explode, the stickies deal massive damage. And now you might be saying, you've tested this, you said earlier you tested these weapons out on all 4 characters, and they're all good on all 4 characters. But this weapon seems to be, you know, kind of like really good for flak, because you can hit crits anywhere on the body. And that is true. Flat can hit crits anywhere on the body, so he kind of benefits from this a little bit. But I've tested this out, like I said, on all four characters, and this thing, as long as you have to actually aim for the critical hit spot on the other three characters, my bad. But as long as you're hitting crits with this thing absolutely shreds. And even if you're not hitting crits, like I said, the normal shots with this thing still do massive damage. But this thing enters like S tier, in my opinion, once you start hitting the crits with it and you get those stickies and those stickies start detonating. This thing just shreds through everything. As you can see through the gameplay, I took out the first set of enemies in Athena's like it was nothing with this thing. This thing is really good. I definitely recommend it, and it definitely deserves to be in the number two spot. Alright, so before we get to our number one spot, I have two honorary mentions. First is going to be the Torg Legendary Assault Rifle, the Laser Sploder. This thing comes in any element except for non-elemental. You cannot get a non-elemental version of this weapon. It drops from King Bobo and during the side mission Rumble in the Jungle in the Voracious Canopy. Basically, this thing shoots a constant laser of damage, and it occasionally shoots out these little rockets that will deal extra damage on top. This thing was close to, like, you know, it's an honorary mention. Also, the other weapon is. So they were both really close to making the list. I just didn't think these two were as good as the other five when it came down to it. But they're still really good assault rifles. You can see here, this thing is definitely doing some really good damage. And we actually just recently covered this weapon in a guide video, I think just like a week or two ago. So it's a fairly new guide video. We just got in on it as well. So, and this thing's in a really good place right now. Pretty good assault rifle, but it just wasn't good enough to make my top five. Alright, for our second honorary mention that did not make the cut, we have another legendary Torg assault rifle, the Alchemist. This thing only comes in the element of fire. It drops from a crew challenge enemy, Heckle and Hyde, in the Jacob's Estate. So basically, what this thing does is you're going to shoot stickies out. That's what this thing does. You shoot stickies on your enemies, and then, you know, after a few seconds, they'll explode. Typical Torg stickies here. But the thing, what this thing does, also, the initial damage is shock, as you're going to see, but whenever they explode, it deals fire damage. Also, what this thing does is every shot you shoot with this thing, it deals shock damage to the player. So, as you can see, that's why I'm taking so much damage, because it's actually dealing shock damage to me. Now, there's a very, very cool combo you can actually pull off with this assault rifle. And what you do, you get your Transformer Shield. The Transformer Shield grants complete resistance to shock damage. And it actually takes that shock damage you take and replenishes your shield with it. So, what you can do with this thing is while you're firing it, you can basically just be keeping your shield up the whole time. And it keeps your shield topped up. That way you're not getting, you know, you're not losing HP and you're not losing shield. It's very good in that aspect, and it was very close to making the top five list, but it just did not make the cut. All right, so coming in at number one on my list is going to be the legendary Vladov assault rifle, the Monarch. The Monarch is a weapon that can drop in any element, including non-elemental. You can get it to drop from Kilovolt during the side quest Kill Kilovolt in Lectra City. In order to get it to drop, though, you will need to be in Mayhem level 6 or higher in order to get the Monarch to drop. Now, this weapon, I mean, all I can say about it is this weapon is absolutely insane. This weapon has been in the game for a little while now, and pretty much since it's been in the game, it's been one of the best assault rifles in the game, ever since they pretty much put it in. And right now, in my opinion, it is the best assault rifle in the game, and I think it's been the best one for a couple months now. And I don't see, I mean, unless they come out with a new legendary or something that can dethrone it, in my opinion, this thing will still be the number one unless they nerf it or something like that or buff something up ridiculously to make it better than this weapon. But if not, this thing is going to be number one for a while. I literally have my whole flak build focused around the Monarch. That's basically what this build is, this build I'm on is built around. But don't let that, don't let that distract you though. This weapon is good and pretty much does what it's doing right here on my flak on pretty much any character you use it on. Zane, Moze, Amara, Flak, does not matter what character you use it on, this weapon is going to shred through everything. It puts out so much damage at a time, especially once you go into turret mode, that means, or the bipod mode. Once you pull out the bipod on the side, you can't run whenever you do it, but it doubles the damage for this thing whenever you do that. And this thing just, it just shreds. It destroys everything in its path. Doesn't matter what character it's on, what build it's in, pretty much. It's going to destroy everything. That's pretty much all I got in this video, guys. Feel free to leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you guys did enjoy it and found it useful. This video will be going up on Monday. That is actually the day of the College Football National Championship, and my favorite team is actually in the College Football National Championship. That'd be Alabama. So that's going to be very interesting to watch. I'm ready to watch that. You'll probably be seeing this. I'll probably get ready to watch it that night. So, yeah, feel free, if you want to, leave your favorite college football team down in the comments section if you want to do that, along with whatever you feel about on the video. But that's all I got in this one. Feel free to leave a like, comment, and subscribe, like I said. And I'll see you guys on the next one.